intoxicating smell of this lady. Once a year, we gather to honor the great cycle of life and death. Every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided. And let us celebrate what it is to be an Addams. Come to me, my luscious wife. Oh, she am I so black and skin so pale. And tell us what it is every Addams hopes for.
Darkness and grief and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk sexy.
When you're an Addams, you need to have a good time. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day. When you're an Addams, you need to have a sense of humor. When you're an Addams,
you need to have a taste for death.
Who cares about the world outside and what it was?
Our first date, you took me to see.
Death over seconds.
How we laugh.
Thank you.
No?
Please, Daddy, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
But we have to tell your mother.
After dinner, when we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept anything from your mother.
Daddy, please. If you love me,
what?
Do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife, say no to my daughter. For this acquisition like you.
You realize what they're asking me to do?
Daddy, one tiny little secret. Please. Please.
Okay.
Thank you, Daddy. Our little secret, right?
Yes, yes. Our little secret.
Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up, as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else would make her father wonder why or why. Wednesday's growing up.
She'll be Thursday before you know it.
A puzzling thing. A secret in the house. A boy, a girl, a ring.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
He's in the kitchen smiling, like this. Maybe it is the boy.
This boy? Ha, I said. And they double ha. Ha, ha.
You yourself said.
Poppy love. Come, darling. I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
Gomez.
On the other hand, she's a healthy young woman, like you were. She could even throw up and get married, like you.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I am much too young to have a married daughter.
Of course. I did not think of that.
Besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, and I have no reason to be saying this.
What if she did meet someone, and that someone stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I will never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course!
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar singles.
No, no.
I think Wednesday I shall have a chat.
Like a bull in the ring, like a moderate right-wing-eyed brat. Like a fly in my tea, or the New York DMV, I'm fat. With my wife to my left, and my daughter to my right, and the thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I could choose, sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground, or like Peter in the round, I'm trapped. I could cry, I could lie, I could sing the other side, but my beauty dice, I rolled up like the trap. Should I beg, should I rage, would they save me in my cage? Ah! Trapped, trapped, trapped. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? That bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back. She smokes the Addams fire, she harbors each desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? She'll pine on me her fear instead of sniveling at me. I'll kick her, that's true, tell me what I must do. Should I gripe? Should I groan? Would I rather pass a stone? Oh, trapped! Wife and wild, crazy child, bitter fear, reconciled, I am trapped! If I'm wrong, I'll be strong, and will try to get it all. Or I'll fail, have to fail, show my coffin to the nail.
If I knock, if I snap,
maybe pain that would be stopped. Then I wouldn't be trapped!
Yeah!
Trapped!
Thank you.
blow up this Lucas guy.
Oh, Huxley. Ever since I met him, everything feels right and wrong. And I want to laugh and cry. And then sometimes, I want to rip off his flesh and eat him all up until there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's not in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled. And I think I know. I'm being pulled in a new direction. But I think I like it. I think I like it.
Nice to meet you.
Okay. Then they'll want to see the house. We'll have dinner at 8, and they'll be back at the hotel by 9:30.
Wednesday, your father's been telling me.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I are having sex.
What about?
This dinner. It all seems so quick.
It's not quick! Oh, Daddy, it's just a simple dinner. And they're dying to meet you. And I promise Lucas. And you know how I hate to break a promise.
Maybe just a little dinner.
Thank you, Daddy.
Well, it seems I've been outvoted, so dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Please, not the game.
It's a family tradition.
It's my dinner.
But it's my house, darling. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Why not the two, Paloma? Don't push it.
Then can we at least try to act normal?
Define normal! Shut up!
Normal is an illusion. What's wrong with the spider is a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please.
Like a nice young man.
But they're not right for each other.
What do you mean they're not right for each other?
was going right for Josephine, but the 80s right, the drum machine, Nazi right for Gramamine. Who's to say? Who's to say? Is ballet right for Balanchine? Is polio right for the salt vaccine? $4 right for gasoline? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trick. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain. But this is their moment and this is your chance.
Out all the street lamps.
Oh, good lord, what is this place?
Acres of bitter. What?
No, this is how they live in New York. They spend all their money on rent and have none left for furniture.
Mal Beinecke. And this is my wife, Alice. And that over there is my son, Lucas. You are... Nice talking to you. Earth to Alice. Landed in Weird City, I say drinks and then bye-bye.
Send welcome in the new. Reach deep in your surprise bag, it might be a gift for you.
bed. So full that I can barely lift it. You know, the guy who had me down at the airport this morning? He slipped his telephone number into my pocket. I don't think I can handle any more surprises. Come on, Dad. Lighten up. They're your type of people. Real salt of the earth. Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715. The Spanish warship, Vigo de Gaia, once captained by my great ancestor, Captain General Redondo Ventana Lecuna Don Jose Pueblo, leaves Madrid bound for the New World. 3 weeks later, he is still in Madrid, as Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man, he set sail anyway, only to sink 6 months later off the southern coast of Florida. A hostile land, infested with mosquitoes, rattlesnakes, and many other peoples. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume, and the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be young Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son, with a massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No matter. The night, she is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home, Gomez Florencia Addams, at your service. I would now like to introduce my wife, La Duena, El Amor de mi Vida, the love of my life, the mother of my children, Morticia.
Sorry I'm late. I was putting the apple pie on the windowsill to cool.
Ah, yes, that's my little woman. A duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez.
And a genius in the bedroom.
So very pleased, Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Addams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
Alice, and you must be Lucas. What a beautiful name.
Thanks. I got it from my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own foot. They don't need to know that.
No, no, it's a beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his own tongue. He talked like this whole world.
Thank you, Mother. Hello, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress.
Aroma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Will you excuse us for a moment?
I won't look at my house. I'm just trying to be normal, okay?
We don't wear bright colors. Bright clothes means no imagination and no inner life. Oh, look, it's everywhere.
It's a wonderful dress, Wednesday. Yellow is the color of the warming sun. Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the love in which we all believe? Why not wear a heart for all to see right here on your sleeve? Yellow!
A lovely sentiment about the color yellow. Ah, it isn't Huxley Addams, Wednesday's brother, just returned from Bible study. Say hello, Huggles.
Hello. Would you like to make a donation?
Oh, of course, sweetheart. What are you collecting for?
Just put some money in the can, and nobody has to get hurt.
Springs, boys.
make toast to the extensive Madam's case.
Children, if you'll excuse.
Lucas, come on. Dad, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma.
Hey, you two, keep a door open, you hear?
Ah, you are worried they will make the peace, eh? Not to worry. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. He tries anything, she'll let me throw it out. You children.
Excuse me! Do you happen to have a little girl's room?
We used to. But we let them all go.
Gomez, come with me, dear. I will show you.
A wonderful idea. A grand tour for the missus. And the mister and I will go below for some guy stuff. And then dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
What kind of game?
Have you ever played charades?
Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Did you get the flowers?
Oh, yes, and the lovely poem, wherever did you find it?
I wrote it.
No.
When I'm depressed or feeling best, a poem will get it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time. They pop out
and always rhyme. Maybe you should see someone about that. We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw it up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. I know it sounds old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, you love me.
Of course.
Then trust me. It's all going according to plan.
What plan? There is no plan.
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's just a simple thing. What could go wrong? Come on.
Aww. Be patient and soon the way will be clear. Don't miss your fear and troubles all will disappear.
Interesting chair. Is it an antique?
15th century, the heretic's chair. Once owned by Tomasi Tokumada, grand inquisitor of the state.
So you collect this stuff?
A man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me, I collect instruments of persuasion. Why, you ask? To wonder. Ask!
Why?
Because it's fun! The history of the world told an agony of dismemberment. Get up, I shall. You sit, they ask you a question, they don't like the answer. Oh, that'll make you believe, eh? Come, sit. Let me ask you a question.
Some other time.
Okie dokie. So, what about these crazy kids, eh?
What about them?
They seem very fond of each other, no?
I mean, I guess, but you know, they're not like getting married or anything.
Of course not. But they do marry young these days, do they not?
I don't know what they do.
Then speak about you, the Barnaby saga, your hopes, your dreams.
Your son. Lucas? A little soft like his mother, but you know, once he graduates college, you know, toughen him up, make him a man, teach him the family business, you know?
May I say something? I feel you and I, we share an image. Do you feel this?
No.
Come, my monkey, let me show you the boat. Did you bring a bathing suit? Ah, forget it. Let's be crazy.
And this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who is that looking over her shoulder?
Oh, no. That's Mother Peg.
She has two heads.
Well, you know what they say.
Who's that man?
That's Uncle Herman Wednesday's uncle twice removed.
I don't understand.
Well, they removed it once, but it grew back. And Mrs. Gomez and I at our wedding.
What's that?
Our wedding vow.
That's so romantic. We promise to tangle at least 3 times a week.
Passion.
We promise to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
And we're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, it sure doesn't work that way in our house.
How does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is nice, quiet goose. If I told about my secrets, I'll help the break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of a marriage where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Of your romance.
So, where does a student get the money for an engagement ring?
Well, I work after school at the bookstore, and on weekends I tutor kids at the charter school. And over summer breaks, I work at my uncle's grocery store.
Is any of this true?
Most of it.
And you're in your time off, why is that?
Mostly I just sit around and think about Wednesday, and how much I love her, and how amazing her life will be together.
So, what does a Lucas Beinecke become when it grows up?
Maybe a writer. Or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner? Why?
You get to look at the inside of people's bodies and they don't mind because they're dead!
Where did you find him?
We found each other. Kind of a miracle. Gomez! Oh my god, Daddy.
What are we gonna do?
Let's just tell her. It'll be fine.
Daddy, you promised after dinner. What are the three of you whispering about?
The weather.
The news.
The economy.
Well, we'll be gone now. See you at dinner.
Come, Lucas. Let me show you the boat. There's an air actress. Big as a dachshund.
No, sir!
Gomez! What's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking. That was conspiring.
No, it was talking. Conspiring, it's... Conspiring.
That's what you were doing!
Getting to stop this foolishness.
You're keeping something from me.
Getting, I have never kept anything from you. In my life, it strike me where I stand if I'm keeping anything from you now.
If it should come to this...
Here, Donna, I bring the urge to take you in my arms.
No, Gomez.
What?
Not today.
But you've never turned out a trip to heaven.
I'll be in my room for you to share like a proper husband.
Morticia mia! Like a plug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man throwing grain when his wife says not to dare. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Conceive it. What if I and one tiny lie start to civil war? What if a lion's beast crosses vows of holy thus? How is that possible? That be possible.
Put the ring on. Just for a minute.
After dinner.
But what if they hate each other?
And what if they don't? Be like me. Look on the bright side.
You make me so crazy.
Maybe two should get a room! Pugsley! Stop sneaking around like that! It's my house too, okay? Excuse me while I kill my brother.
Let me handle this. It's the bugs! What's up, little man?
Trying to be cool?
Yep.
Because you're not cool.
Your sister thinks I'm cool.
She'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
I'm under a lot of stress right now. My sister's having a little identity crisis. We're gonna go now. Can I come? Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye. But wait! What if she walks away, leaving?
Another magnificent feast! All thanks to my beautiful lady wife from whom I keep nothing. This dinner puts me in the mind of my great ancestor, Fernando Escondido Chimichanga. A man hated by the church, cleverly quick. Whilst he burnt at the stake, he said to the priest, even pink in the middle and a little crispy on the outside.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Dun, dun, dun!
Please, not the game. It's getting really late. But it's a family tradition. Pugsley, could you just go away and die? I will if your boyfriend will.
Cara, maybe the game's a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, then somebody will be sitting on the couch for a very long time.
Actually, the game is a good idea. The best of all ideas.
What kind of game?
It's called Obligación de Revelar.
What's Spanish? What does it mean?
Everyone drinks from the sacred family chalice.
And confess the secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
For what?
For there are consequences.
Why would I be right to the back end?
Of course you're right.
Oh.
Thank you.
My husband has nothing to disclose.
No, no. The host goes last.
Lord, a sacred chalice.
This is the sacred chalice from Adam's family's past. Remember my dish on his palace, held fast.
Guide us.
Here in the sweet libation, salvation resides. Feel the sweet sensation, revelation provides. Let your darkest secrets keep you away. Face your demons in the Napoli say, I pray. Once there was a man who had a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the ground she walked on. Thank you. And then one day, the man happened upon a fox who gave him a box of rare wood and Spanish leather. What's in the box? Asked the kindly man. And the fox said, oh, just a little secret, nothing important, but you must never open it. So the kindly man took it home, and his wife said, let's open it anyway. And the kindly man said, don't push it, honey, we got a good thing going. And then they never did open it. Full disclosure.
Disclosure, it's the moment.
Grateful Dead t-shirt? Is he ever coming back?
How long do I have to wait?
Thank you.
make it out of here alive.
Well, Beinekes, looks like you'll be spending the night. That's what happens when you play.